Welcome back to our YouTube channel.
Daddy used to take me walking down the street. Daddy used to take my hand, say follow me. Daddy used to leave me back home all the time. I got big enough to run around, daddy left me outside.
Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. For those of you that are tuning in for the first time, welcome and thank you for checking us out. Please do enjoy, please do subscribe. And yeah, for today's video, we'll be talking about the design illustration. It's one of the steps in the design process. The design process, first of all, is long. We cannot cover all of that in one video. But today we're just going to be talking about the design illustration. How to make one, how to draw for fashion, what is important when you're drawing for fashion. And yeah, just the basics though, for the beginners. The equipment that you'll be needing is your pencil, preferably a clutch pencil. We might or might not be using your colored pencil because we'll be using, we might be using the Copic markers because I love using the Copic markers, guys. Since I was introduced to them and quasi Wheeler app, but if you have your colored pencils and you can use them, it's all good. Like, we still use this every once in a while. And then you're gonna need your eraser. You're gonna see why. All of the stuff that I'm showing you right now is just an equipment, but you can see why you're gonna need each and every one of them. You're gonna need this. There's a front and the back. It basically shows you every little detail and a proportion of a body of a person. That way, your garment, it sits wherever it's supposed to. So important. And then you might need these as well. These are basically just models. These are the figures of the models, basic figures of models. I still use this right now. Some people don't. You can just draw someone perfectly and get proportion that's perfect. Good for you. However, this is quicker because you just trace this thing off, get everything in proportion still. Again, that is the very important thing in drawing for fashion is proportion. Fine, but proportion is super important. Things have to sit exactly how you intend them to, and it has to show when you're drawing. Because bear in mind, you might not be drawing just for yourself to see the design. You might not be drawing with your partner. So your partner is to see what's in your head. So if I bone you from the drawing, then it's gonna hinder the whole process. So yeah, you got those. I'm going to show you my favorite one, so I'm going to be using one of these two figures. Ah, look at that. Because to be honest, these body types are not popular in the fashion world, to be honest, not enough at least. So we'll be using one of these. I think we might be using this figure, but we'll see. And then, yeah, that's it. That's it, really. Okay, so we'll be starting with tracing off the basic model. You're going to put it under the paper you're going to be using and trace it off. And try by all means to trace it off lightly because we want to see the garment on top of the model more than we want to see the actual model. And yeah, you don't have to trace off everything, all of the lines. You want to trace off the lines that you think you're going to need for your dress to see, you know, like your bust point. You're obviously going to need to see where the boobs are going to be and the waist. elbows, shoulders, all of the important parts. So we do have the longer models as well. If you think your garment is going to be longer than the knees, so you can get that instead of this one, which is basically a half. After that, that's when you put the drawing on top of the model. That's where you start designing. Try and put all the details you want to put at the stage of designing. All of them, everything you could think of. This usually takes longer than the other steps. Because this is where you think. You stop and think for a second. How I want the sleeves to look. Basically everything. Is it going to work? You have to think, is it going to be practical? Is it going to be cute? Is it going to represent everything that I am as a designer or whoever you're designing for? So you have to consider all of those things, and you have to label your dress or your garment. We try to do a simple dress here for the sake of this video. And then from there, you trace off your model. This is the second stage, which is basically the one that you will be styling. This is the model you'll be styling. This is where you're going to try and be cute about your about your design. This is basically the design, rather the drawing that sells your dress or your design. You have to pick the right model, or rather the model that you wanted to design for. It's always good to have different body types of different models, because you might not be designing for the same type of a model, unless you are. You're that kind of designer that has a specific body type they design for. But yeah. And this at this stage, what you have to consider is how your model is going to look like when they're wearing the dress. Because they're not standing straight. You have to think about that too. They're not standing straight, and therefore the clothing has to sit how it would when a person standing like that, you know, is wearing it. And then when you're using Copic markers now, you trace off the outlines of the models first before you color in. I think most people do that even with the colored pencils. They trace off so that they don't make much of a mess. And by the way, Copic markers have two ends. I didn't mention that before. They have two ends, the flat surface, which is basically a flat, thick surface, square-shaped like, and then you have a thick end. And with that flat surface, you usually have to put the color first, and then you put the details with the thin surface. You know, for instance, the knees won't be the same color as the legs, because they usually have more pigment. You have to consider the lighting, the shading, you know, so that has to show even on your dress. Even on the actual dress. And by the way, what's most important when drawing is the actual dress or the actual garment, more than the model. So you have to make sure your dress is exactly how you intended to. It looks the way you had it in your head. At least it's closest to that. So you can, it really doesn't matter how you color in your legs and your face and your, you know, your shoes and whatnot, even though it's always nice to, you know, do the right thing. It's always nice to color in the right way throughout your design. But put more emphasis on the dress, on the garment. That's the one thing we're trying to sell here. So yeah, you always go over you know, where the dress is going to be creasing or where it's folded or gathered, because obviously the color is not the same. And you, this is where you try for your dress or your design, rather, to look as 3D as possible. It has to look real. It has to look how it would when a person was actually wearing it. And yeah, usually when designing, you usually put the fabric you're going to be using. Sometimes knowing the fabric you're going to be using when you design, it helps you a bit more with how the dress is going to look. At this stage, at this specific design, we're going to be using a stretch satin material, and that way we get to see if a stretch satin drapes a certain way. Obviously it's going to sit a certain way. It's not going to be structured, it's just going to fall on the body, you know. It's going to be flowy. Rather than, say, if you were using a suiting material or any other structured material, this dress would look completely different. So yeah, that's why we pinned a fabric next to our model over there. When drawing your face, you can be as abstract as you want. Sometimes I don't put the other eye. Sometimes I know other people, sometimes they don't even put the features of the face. They just draw the structure of the face and leave it like that. Like, you can be abstract, you can put detail if you want. You can, you know, take your time with your face of the model. It's all up to you. And there it is. There's our model looking cute. And yeah, guys, I hope this was helpful. I hope you learned a lot from this tutorial. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to comment on our comment section below. And don't hesitate to, you know, to give us suggestions. How do you draw your illustrations? And yeah, thank you. Bye.